You're very kind. I appreciate it. That's a great song, man. Beautiful song. I was in Baton Rouge, and I was keeping up with our boy Jimmy, and I don't know when those guys had time to write the sermons. I mean, these guys are rock and roll, you know. But I understand that ministers are just men, and that sometimes, you know, those juices flow and the pleasure of the flesh. I understand that. But let me point this out. Jimmy Swaggart, according to what I read, was making $40 million a month. Now, to be a good television evangelist, all you really got to be able to do is cry and sweat. If you can get crying and sweating down, you got it, you know. Now, I'm going to tell you something about old Jimmy. I like Jimmy. I like to watch his show. I believe God takes the Jimmy Swaggart show. I really do. Old Jimmy can do it now. They get to crying and sweating with the best of them. I promise you that. But let me tell you this. If I were going to risk $40 million a month, all you got to do is show up once a week and sweat and cry, right? $40 million. If I was going to risk $40 million a month, I promise you, I would have wound up with something a lot better looking than Sweat Hog he wound up with in that motel room. True. We'd find you a fine looking woman for $40 million, I'm telling you that. I'm telling you, that woman's that knock a dog off a gut wagon. That child's ordering a bowling shoe. I never seen nothing like that. God. I am a Methodist. Do we have any? How many Methodists we got here? I'm a Methodist. I grew up in the Methodist Church, Moreland Methodist Church, my little hometown. We didn't have the two churches. We had a Methodist Church and a Baptist Church. We had some Presbyterians. We ran them out of town. But Baptists are just a little bit tighter than Methodists. You know, they just a little, like Baptists won't make love standing up. Somebody might think they're dancing. But the Baptists are getting a little more liberal now. They're starting to wave at one another, liquor stores. Used to it's like this, you know. The Methodists move their preachers around. The Baptists don't do this. We move our preachers around. And Moreland was such a small little town. We used to get those AAA preachers, you know, those guys just out of seminary. We always get young guys, you know, 21, 22 years old, their first church. And it was a very poor town, and nobody had any money, so we couldn't even buy them cars, you know, the Baptist and Methodist Church. We gave our preachers bicycles. And every Sunday morning, the two preachers would meet in front of the Masonic Lodge there in Moreland on the bicycles, and they would discuss matters of theology and their sermons of the day and so forth. One day, the Baptist preacher walked up on foot. The Methodist preacher said, "Brother, where's your bicycle?" The Baptist preacher said, "I believe a member of my congregation has stolen my bicycle." The Methodist minister was appalled. He was a guest. He said, "Brother, I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to help you now. I'm going to tell you how to get that bicycle back." He said, "I want you to get that pulpit this morning. I want you to make them feel that fire. I want you to make them smell that brimstone. I want you to preach on the Ten Commandments. And when you come to thou shalt not steal, I want you to back on it. Whoever got your bicycle, get the feeling bad and bring it back to you." He said, "I tried." 2 weeks passed. Sure enough, the Baptist preacher came back on his bicycle. The Methodist preacher was thrilled. He said, "Hallelujah, a miracle has occurred. Did you do what I told you to do? Did you make them feel that fire? Did you make them smell that brimstone? Did you preach on the Ten Commandments when you came to thou shalt not steal? Did you bow down on it? Whoever got your bicycle, get the feeling bad and bring it back too." The Baptist preacher said, "Not exactly." He said, "I did preach on the Ten Commandments. But when I come to thou shalt not commit adultery, I remember where I left my bicycle." Now, my grandfather, Bun Word, was a Baptist. My mama was a Baptist. She married my dad's Methodist. I became Methodist. But my grandfather was a foot-washing Baptist. Now, that's a little devil. He believed in washing feet and all that. And he also believed that preachers shouldn't have notes. He quit going to church, and he found out, he thought us would be zapped right on the back of the head and run out the mouth, you know, right there. He didn't believe in notes. When my granddaddy died, bless his heart, he was a great old man. We took him all the way back to Heard County, Georgia, his hometown where he grew up, poorest county in the state of Georgia. Took him all the way back over there for the Pleasant Grove Baptist Church, Primitive Baptist Church. And had one of them funerals lasted all afternoon. I mean, he'd get one preacher up there, he'd get to holler and get out of breath. He'd move him off, bring another nun. He'd get good rock and roll. He'd take his coat off and sling it. They'd bring another nun. And finally, long, about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, we've been there since 1, they brought a little boy out there, and he got really excited. He wants somebody to testify. He said, I want somebody in this congregation to stand up and testify. I want somebody to stand up and testify about the clutches of the devil. And the fellow in the back said, I'll do it, preacher, I'll testify. And the preacher said, well, I want you to tell it all now, brother. I want you to tell it all. And the fellow said, last week I took my paycheck, and I didn't take it home to my wife and my family. I went and wasted it all on liquor and beer. And the preacher said, tell it all, brother, tell it all. He said, in the week before that, I took my paycheck and started taking it home to my family. I went out and I gambled and lost all my money. And the preacher said, tell it all, brother, tell it all. And the week before that, I lied to my employer, said I was sick. I wasn't sick. I laid out with an old woman. He said, tell it all, brother, tell it all. And the fellow said, last Tuesday, I had sex with a goat. Preacher said, damn, brother, don't believe I told that.